Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another episode of Fantastic Nature Adventures. I'm Nat Ermson, and this is the final video that I made up in Maine. What this video is really about is all of the different larger animals that call the pond where my grandparents live on home. So, for example, the three creatures that I'm going to be featuring in this video, it's two mammals and one species of bird. These three creatures, I think, are particularly interesting animals that actually need this pond to survive. And I've just found, you know, a lot of, you know, reptiles and insects and that kind of stuff on my channel for years, but I haven't really done too many videos focusing on the larger animals, such as mammals and birds. So obviously this one is a little bit unique because I'm not really searching for animals, I'm more just, you know, filming them and stuff. But anyway, guys, hopefully you enjoyed this different style of video. The animals that I found were really cool. One of the animals that I found while canoeing on the pond was the North American river otter. Now, I had never seen a wild river otter in my life before, so I was really, really excited to be able to film this. And basically, North American river otters, they live all across North America. They live from the western United States up into Canada and then back down into the eastern United States. They're kind of absent from the Midwest and the South, really, but they do have a very large range in that sort of northern temperate region of North America. And the river otter is a really cool animal. They're mustelids, so they're in the same family as badgers, skunks, you know, those kind of animals, weasels, and they're highly sociable. The ones that I saw were actually a family of river otters. I think it was, you know, a male, female, and then a couple of pups, because we heard the pups sort of squealing in the reeds, but we didn't actually get to see the pups. And what was really cool was the father or the mother, I'm not exactly sure, was basically trying to distract us from, you know, getting too close to those pups with our canoe by sort of swimming a little ways away and kind of just bobbing its head up and down and sort of like calling at us to make sure we kind of get distracted and not go too close to the pups, which is a really cool defense mechanism. Another thing about river otters that's pretty cool is they are voracious predators. They're not like, you know, apex predators, of course, because they're not very big. They're only about, you know, 2 feet long, but they do eat a lot of small animals that live on the pond. They eat frogs, muskrats, birds, all sorts of animals they will eat, and they really are pretty cool. They just kind of live on the, you know, they're sort of an amphibious mammal. They live on the side of the water, on the shorelines, and they go in the water to, you know, collect food and all that kind of stuff. And yeah, it was really cool to see some of these, because I've never ever seen actual river otters in the wild before. I've seen them many times at zoos, but to see them in the wild is honestly much cooler. So yeah, that was the first animal we saw. The animal we definitely saw the most of when canoeing on the pond was, of course, the North American beaver, which is the largest species of rodent in North America. The North American beaver is truly a very, very unique and iconic animal throughout all of North America. Basically, all of the United States and all of Canada is where it lives. And this animal, of course, is famous for making beaver dams, which the primary purpose of a beaver dam is so that the beaver can, so that the beaver families can have a body of water that doesn't completely freeze over in the wintertime. Because what beavers actually do in the winter is they can actually swim under the ice and continue to get, you know, wood and stuff for their houses even during the coldest months of the winter. And of course, the beaver dams are made by, you know, the beavers chopping down the trees with their huge, huge rodent incisors, and then taking those logs from the trees and sort of gluing all the logs together with mud, and that's how they make a beaver dam. And basically that makes it so that the water isn't flowing, it's just a still, you know, non-flowing water pond. And this exact pond that my grandparents live on is a pond that is made by beavers. It's a totally natural pond that the beavers created through the dam building process. Another thing that's really interesting that a lot of people don't actually know about beavers is they make these canals as well. And beaver canals are basically these sort of small, like, I guess, mini rivers that go basically out of the pond, kind of like, you know, spider's web kind of thing, where they just kind of keep going out of the pond as sort of extensions, and that way the beavers can basically swim into these canals, go right into the forest, and, you know, get the trees that they need to get without, you know, being easily noticed by a predator. And also, beavers are just much faster moving in the water than they are on land. They're truly an amphibious mammal. And yeah, beavers are super, super cool. You know, I've been going up to my grandparents' place for my entire life, and I've always seen beavers every single time I go up there. They're a total staple creature. And their houses as well are really cool because they actually provide not only warmth for them in the wintertime, but they also provide homes for muskrats, which also live in their houses. And beaver houses are really cool. Beaver dams are really cool. Beavers literally create the ecosystem of the entire pond, which is just, in my opinion, mind-blowing, that this animal that's only about, you know, 3 or 4 feet long at the most can create an entire ecosystem just by, you know, putting some sticks and logs with some mud. It's amazing. But anyway, beavers are really cool. They make, you know, they have a very social, you know, lifestyle. They have whole families that live in these houses, and there's a lot of beavers on the pond. The signature thing that beavers do when you get close to them is they slap the water really hard with their huge flat paddle tail, and that makes a very, very loud sound, and that basically signifies to all the other beavers that are swimming around on the pond that there's danger. So almost every single time I would approach a beaver in my canoe, the beaver would slap its tail, and that way it would notify the other beavers to get away from, you know, me, which they think is a potential predator. So anyway, beavers are super, super cool. They're really fascinating. And yeah, beavers are just honestly probably the most important animal in this entire ecosystem. This whole pond ecosystem is the North American beaver. The most beautiful animal that I saw in the pond was the common loon, which is of course not a mammal, but of course a bird. Now, loons are really, really interesting, really beautiful, and super iconic, especially in Canada, where their coins are actually called loons because the coins actually have a loon on them. And obviously in America, they're very well known as well for their call and just their very iconic look. They're a really, really amazing bird. Loons spend the fall and the winter out in the open ocean looking for fish, and then they pair, and then they fly inland to a river or a pond and decide to make a nest and have young. Now, there was a loon family on our pond that was super cool. We saw the male out on the water for the most part, pretty much always on the water, but the female was sitting on the eggs a lot of times. And when I first got there, or when we first found the nest, there were actually 2 eggs. Now, sadly, my grandparents have informed me that one of the eggs did not make it, but the other one apparently has hatched into a baby loon. And, you know, ponds and inland areas like this are really good habitat to raise a family for these loons because there's not a ton of predators. And what the loon will do is they will actually have a nest right on the edge of the pond, like literally right on the edge. So if there's any predators, the mother can just dart into the water super, super fast, which, you know, is good for the parents. And I mean, if a predator did come and take the eggs, it would be very devastating. But loons sometimes are able to make a new clutch of eggs before the season ends. Loons are really, really beautiful. They have these bright red eyes, which is kind of creepy looking, but it looks super iconic. They've also, of course, got this, you know, iconic black and white speckling on their body. They've got the very iconic loon call, and they're pretty big. They're probably close to 2 feet long, and loons are really, really, really well adapted. In the UK and in other parts of Europe, they're actually called divers because loons are so adapted to living in water that they can't even really walk on land. They basically spend their entire time basically swimming, looking for fish, or if it's a female, laying and sitting on eggs. But they really just swim or fly. They never really walk around. You're never gonna see a loon just walking around on land. And loons are just super, super interesting birds. They really have a pretty chill life. They basically, you know, live out in the open ocean. That's their little vacation, I guess. Then they come in, make a family for a few months, you know, in a nice, serene pond like the one my grandparents live on. Then they go back out, and catch more fish. It's really quite a chill lifestyle. Now, what was really cool was the loon that we saw was the mother loon for the most part, because she was the one that was sitting on the eggs, so it was easy to film her. And the more times we saw her and the more times she sort of, you know, saw us and recognized us as who we were, she was able to begin to trust us as not being proper predators. So one time we were able to get super, super, super close, and she was still just sitting on the eggs as if we were just gonna be, you know, observing, which is exactly what we did. We just sat there and we just observed, took some footage, took some pictures, and it was really, really iconic to see the loon, you know, really begin to trust us as just onlookers rather than proper predators. Anyway, guys, hopefully you enjoyed this video. Loons, beavers, and otters were the three big animals that I saw on the pond. There's also a lot of other animals that we just didn't get to see. You know, there's moose out there, there's bears, bobcats, minks, there's all sorts of stuff, fisher cats, there's all sorts of different mammals and stuff, and of course other birds as well that I personally just didn't see on this trip because they're just so much more elusive. But anyway, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. I know it's a bit more like my classic videos where I kind of just narrate the whole thing rather than sort of have myself on the location filming it. But anyway, guys, that's the end of my main adventures, my main saga, I guess you could say. And I'm not really sure if I'm going to be making any more videos, to be honest, because I have about two or three more weeks of chilling in New York before I have to go back up to Maine for college. And you know, once I'm in college, I'm gonna be in college mode. I'm gonna be trying to make new friends. I'm gonna be trying to do well in my classes. So I might not be able to make that many videos, especially not initially with COVID and everything. But hopefully you guys are looking forward to new content. I still do wanna try to get to 100 subscribers by the end of 2020. Hopefully I will be making some more videos before this year ends. But anyway, for now, that's gonna be it for me for maybe a month or two, maybe more. But yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed these 7 or 8 videos I made up in Maine. And yeah, if you did, please give it a like. And remember, I'm trying to get to 100 subscribers by the end of 2020. So if you would be so kind to subscribe, it would be really nice. I know I don't upload very often, and I know my videos are not top notch, but they're really just, you know, nice nature videos. There's not really any harm in subscribing. So yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed this. I'm Nat Ermson. Peace out, and I will see you guys sometime soon. Goodbye.